Good morning, Goofy Squad. Welcome back to my channel, guys. It's your girl, Malia Angelique, and I'm... Oh. No, I didn't start my car. Not you on the phone. But I'm in the car. You already know what happens in the car.
My connection bad.
So, I have to go to work today. But no, Princess freaking wanted some Starbucks. So that's what we gotta do. Go get Princess some Starbucks. Before I go to work, I like to relax. I don't like to be doing stuff. Even though I'm supposed to wake up 3 hours before I go to work because I like taking my precious time. But that didn't happen today. Oh, y'all look a little bit crooked. Is that better? Yes, this is better. So that's what we're doing right now. But she said she's going to get me a vanilla bean frappe. No whipped cream. And I love the pound cake. That's all I get.
Charger,
exactly, but you're gonna be without a charger.
No, I'm not gonna bike you, same day.
No, I'm just kidding. I'll be going without chargers. I'll be like, dang, I don't got no charger. Like, on my own, like, my birthday weekend, I had no charger. I was borrowing chargers. Because I just did not feel like going to get me home. My own charger. But everybody else around me got a charger. I was trying to run that way until I get home.
Questions.
What? She just said, I'll see you soon.
Oh my God, girl. When you have, what? Princess, you have to be on your job. You have to act like you want your job. Like, if you don't want your job, be you right now. So let me be you right now.
I didn't know that you had to, like.
Yes, so you know when to come in.
Well, he was like, because he was like, he would send the rest of the, like, I'm in the group chat, and he was like, I will send the rest of the schedule.
But you need to ask just in advance. You can't just be waiting for them. How about Lee, what y'all doing today? Why y'all breaking like
this? This is my first job. Give me some slack.
No, listen, you don't get no slack. This is common sense. We hard. You, how you going to be having a job and don't know when the next time you're going to come in? You can't be sitting there waiting like a duck. You need to know. So then you can prepare. Because what if something came up? What if you, they wanted you to work, but you end up planning something because you didn't know when the next time you was going to go to work?
Okay, I text on that girl. I need one. Anyways, figure out when the next time I'm going to come in. I know it's this week. So, we're just seeing when that is.
Go in.
There's person got in.
Oh.
Not one person, but
technically, it was going to be.
What are they doing with this? What are they going to build right here since they're building a new McWendy's right there? I don't know why they blocked that off. Right, if they didn't block it off, we'd be headed this car in front of us. Talking about some baby on board. Do people actually read that and decide, hey, I'm just not going to hit you because you have a baby on board? I watched a video on Instagram, and like it was like a baby in like a car seat thingy, and she was leaned over in the middle of the road. And I was like, whoa. And so, like, it was like the video, he had to fat, like, rewind it. And when he rewinded it, basically, a car was in front of him and the car door opened. But how it, like, opened, somebody had to open it. And, like the car seat can't just come out because you buckle the car seat down and then you put your child in. So, how it happened was the door, how it opened, it didn't just fling open. So, like, the door opened and the baby just, like, the car seat just rolled out and they just kept going. Like, one, how do you not notice that? And two, like, the door, basically was open and didn't shut back. Like, how do you not notice? Like, I don't know. And, like, the baby was just, like, in the car seat just sitting there.
It'd be crazy. People don't care about their babies.
It was in traffic and, like, people stopped the car. I mean, like, stopped their cars to, like, be like, what the heck? I was like, what the hell? Like, how does that just happen? People crazy. And then there was just like, they didn't want that baby, obviously, because, like, how do you not pay attention like that?
Because clearly they purposely put the baby outside the car and left the baby there.
No, they didn't put her out. They threw her out. Like, the car, like, if the car was going, they opened the door and the baby just rolled out the car. That's how it happened. Just open the door. I think they threw it. I had a video I would like to show y'all, but
that's crazy.
I wanna see.
Mm-hmm. But this almost line is long and I gotta go to work. She always got me doing stuff. She always got me doing stuff. Ouch. I get off work. Bring mom some ice. Why? I'm not eating the ice. So why do I, when she's already home, and go get her own ice? But no, me, I just got off work. I want to relax.
Oh, here it is.
But no, I have to go get some freaking ice.
What happened a year ago? But I had just seen it.
That's how the news be working sometimes. Stuff be happening. Like, past happened, and we just not know.
Okay.
She's gonna show you this video.
Not properly installed in the vehicle. It is the heart-stopping video capturing this terrifying moment. Watch as this gray car comes around a curb in Mankato, Minnesota.
Apparently, a child fell out of a child's seat out of the back of the vehicle.
Look again. The rear driver's side door swings open, and then a toddler, who is still strapped in her car seat, tumbles into the middle of the road. The car continues to drive away as the door slams shut on its own. The moment was captured by Chad Mock's dash cam video. He couldn't believe what he'd seen.
I stopped, got out, and honked my horn several times and tried to flag down the person that lost the child out the back, and they just kept going.
Authorities say the driver of that gray vehicle didn't notice the child had fallen out of the vehicle.
She went through an intersection, and at some point she pulls her car over to the side of the road. It appeared that, you know, she left her car running and all of that. She just basically runs back to the incident location to try to locate her child.
The toddler, miraculously, was uninjured.
She wasn't, you know, out of it or anything, but just very calm, very alert.
It does appear that the child was restrained in the child seat. However, it wasn't tethered or strapped into the vehicle itself properly.
Experts say it's a common problem.
What you guys think? Because I think
that she knew.
She, how you
not?
If your door swings open, the car indicates when a door's open, and then there's weight to it. Like even if it's wind, like there's weight, your car will know that your door is open or something. And like, how you not look back? Everybody, most of the time when you're driving, you're looking back. You're not just looking straight. You're always looking around your surroundings.
When I was younger, like probably like 5, and Juwan was like 4. And like it was like my mom, my brother Saeed, and it was like me and this part and Juwan in that part. So we were driving down this road and his door flung open. Like he was just, and then Juwan was just sitting, like, cause he was leaning on his door. So then the door just flung open. Juwan was just, so we had pulled Juwan back in, and it was like me and Juwan was so small. So we just like closed the door. It was like, but mommy knew, like mommy, like,
she's like, you cannot know. And then second of all, why you don't have your daughter strapped in? I'm more the toddler strapped in. Like,
ain't no
you didn't care. You didn't care.
You can't be lazy to strap your child in.
Guys, like if you birthed that baby, like you're not gonna forget to securely strap the baby in. Because if you strapped in, why can't the baby be strapped in? Like, come on now, there's safety procedures for a reason.
That video was crazy, y'all.
And like, I can understand the door being shut after, because I mean, if it's a windy day and you're driving fast, yeah, that door's gonna shut on its own.
But then you're gonna hear that, and I feel like you immediately stop your car and look back. Like,
and then there's somebody honking, of course you're gonna look back. You're not gonna keep driving. Why would you keep driving? Somebody honking, trying to catch your attention.
And then most parents, they already be looking in the mirror at their child 24/7. Like, you know, your parents like look up, make sure their child sleep or see what their child doing. So it just makes no sense that you just kept driving.
Yeah, so you know, guys, what do y'all think? Because you know,
I think
I'm a mind my business.
Yeah, she probably gonna come.
You see me, you see me.
Y'all know what I want to try?
We don't have no babies over here.
I want to try an acai bowl. They look so good.
A what bowl?
Acai bowl.
Y'all already, if y'all haven't watched the
oh my God,
our earphone challenge, it's so funny. It's so funny. Because Princess pronunciations, it's hilarious. It's hilarious.
It's really fall.
Sweetheart.
I need to take a picture of this. It's really fall out here, y'all.
But yeah, we're still in the line, and I usually be already getting ready for work, be dressed for work, ate breakfast and everything.
Girl, you don't even have breakfast.
Oh no! Cause today's gonna be a long day. I gotta work 10:30 to 7. At least I ain't gotta close again because I dislike closing.
Okay, it won't let me get the picture.
I dislike it. But I'm gonna be working because next week I only have 20 hours. No ma'am. No ham, no turkey, no none of that.
Well,
I need to be working 30 plus hours a week. I need to.
I want that picture.
But yeah, we're gonna order our Starbucks, leave. Princess, what you say? You're told them what you're getting?
Yeah, two warmed up muffins and a
blueberry muffins and
two blueberry warmed up muffins and a Ruben, hold on, I'm gonna make sure. That's
because I'm just gonna get my vanilla bean. Probably, what's the smallest? Venti, right?
Tall. Venti is the largest, girl.
Oh. A tall vanilla bean fried with no whipped cream and a lemon pound cake. Cause who don't get lemon pound cake?
Yeah, it's called a.
The icing be the one only thing that really hits. You know, it just tops it off.
Oh, perfect. I'm gonna get a caramel Ruben crunch cream frappe.
Thank you for checking this double Starbucks. This is Sean speaking. How can I help you today?
Hi, could I have a tall vanilla bean frappe with no whipped cream?
Tall vanilla bean frappuccino with no whip. What else can I get for you?
And a lemon pound cake slice.
And you want a lemon pound cake?
Yes, please.
Anything else for you?
A caramel Reuben crunch cream.
Okay. A caramel ribbon.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, a caramel ribbon crunch cream frappe.
Grande.
Okay, what else can I get for you?
And could you make that size grande?
Okay.
And then 2 blueberry muffins warmed up, please.
Okay.
That'll be all.
Great, 1871, we'll see you at the window.
Okay, thank you.
That says ribbon, not Reuben. That's why I was confusion. Chris don't know how to read. I'm like, Reuben.
I only have this much left on my card.
The $50 that I gave you?
Yes.
Gary, you've been swiping.
No, this one came to $18.
I thought he said 8.
Because I had $44 still left, and now I only got 25, so I spent half of it. But then I got another 25 one. So I still got $50 worth of Starbucks. Oh. Then I got money. Don't come for me. Anyways, I want there to be a prom. So apparently homecoming is canceled. This girl went off on Snapchat because people were doing a foco, whatever that was, like a fake homecoming. Fake hoco, but they called it a foco. And like a lot of people like went to it, and then the girl was like, y'all don't care about nobody, like there's reasons why people can't see their grandparents because of y'all, because y'all want to go and do your own homecoming. Like, why do y'all think it was canceled in the first place for people's safety? She just like, I want to read it. Like,
first of all, she can't be going off, because at the end of the day, it's their decisions to go. It's not like it's mandatory at all. Like, if you choose to do that, you choose to do that. You didn't have to.
Let me see.
Like, come on now. So okay.
She said, are y'all forgetting we're in the middle of a pandemic? Like, I don't understand what's not clicking. Homecoming being canceled does not give you an excuse to have your own with big A-word groups. Every single one of y'all who went to a FOCO are selfish. You guys are the reason some of us can't see our grandparents and other elders and higher risk family members. You guys should be disappointed in yourself.
Nah.
In all caps, it does not matter if it's senior year. You guys could be killing people and you don't seem to care. So selfish and irresponsible.
She probably mad because she couldn't go herself. Her mama said, sweetheart, no, you can't go. So sit your behind down. Period. Like, come on now. You can't get mad. Like, people still traveling. She probably went somewhere and still traveling. She ain't staying in no house. She's not staying in no house. So why are you getting mad at somebody else because they making a decision that they want to make? There's a whole bunch of illness out there killing anybody. Like, come on now. It's crazy. You can't keep somebody contained at home. Like, that's not happening. Because I bet her behind go to Starbucks, or I bet her behind go to Chick-fil-A. They be surrounded by a whole bunch of people all the time. Come on now, sweetheart. It's crazy. Crazy. That's how I just feel about this coronavirus. Like, I mean, yeah, it's like, you want to stay protected and all and everything, but it's like, you're not selfish if you want to still live your life. That's just how I feel. Because I'm going to Vegas. And I'm still having fun, but I'm going to make sure I'm protected. Me and my friends, we protected. Like, we're not going to be around people that's doing too much. Like, coughing or sneezing. No. We're going to keep our safe distance. But we're still going to have fun. We're still going to live our lives. My life is not going to be put on hold because freaking coronavirus, because people don't want to be clean or stuff like that, you know? No. Because people should have been washed their hands, been covered their mouth when they sneeze or cough, been took care of things like that. So, I feel pressed when people be like, it's selfish. You're mad that I want to live my life and not be in solitude and isolation? Okay. But, told you guys later, it kind of like triggered me, you know? In a way, and I can't be getting mad because I'm trying to be calm, because I be having real rage, sweetheart. So, like all YouTubers say, like, comment, share, and subscribe. We'll be back with more videos. Peace.